हेलो फ्रेंड्स, यू आर वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल मैक पीएम। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर टॉपिक रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ बीम्स। सो वी हैव अनदर क्वेश्चन इन विच ए कैंटिलीवर ऑफ लेंथ 2 मीटर दिस लेंथ 2 मीटर कैरीज अ पॉइंट लोड ऑफ 20 kN एट फ्री एंड दिस वन एंड अनदर लोड 20 kN एट इट्स सेंटर। सो दिस इज सेंटर, सो इट इज 1 मीटर एंड दिस डिस्टेंस इज ऑल्सो 1 मीटर एंड टोटल इज 2 मीटर। If E is equal to, so it is given that L is equal to 2 meter, E is equal to 10 to the power 5 Newton per mm square. So, and I is given as 10 to the power 8 mm to the power 4. So, we have to calculate the bending moment diagram. We have to draw the bending moment diagram because we have to use the area moment method. So we will draw lines through all the loads and support, and bending moment will be negative because these loads are causing hobbing moment. So at this point bending moment will be 0 because 20 into 0 will be 0, and at this point it will be 20 into 1. So this will be 20 and this is a straight line, inclined line. Now at this point what will be the bending moment? So bending moment at A is equal to 20 into this one, sorry, 20 into 2, 1 plus 1, 2 plus 20 into 1, so it will be 60 kN meter. Okay, so this will become, this is 20, this will become 60, this is 60. Okay, we are not writing unit because of space constraint. We have less space, so we will draw a parallel line from here so that we can calculate area easily. So suppose this is 1 and this is 2 and this is 3 parts, so that we can denote it. Then area A1 will be, this area A1 will equal to half, this is triangular, so half into base into height, so half into base is 1 meter and height is this 20, it is in kilonewton meter. Okay, sorry, kilonewton into meter square, because this load is in, this is in kilonewton meter, so it is in kilonewton meter, 20 kilonewton meter into this, is this length is in meter, so it is in kilonewton meter square. So if you will convert, because all the units are given in newton per mm square or mm to the power 4, so we have to convert into it into newton mm to the power mm square, so it will become 20 into 1000, it will convert into newton, into 10 to the power 3 to the power square to convert meter square into mm square, so it will become 20 into 10 to the power 3 plus 6, 9, or 2 into 10 to the power 10 newton mm square. Okay, so this is area A1. Now area A2 will be base into height, it is rectangular area, so it will be base into height, so base is 1 into height is this 20, so 20 kilonewton meter square, so if you multiply it by 10 to the power 9, then it will become 2 into 10 to the power 10 newton mm square. Okay, now area A3 will become half into base into height, so base is 1 into height is this 60 minus 20 is 40, so it will become 20 kilonewton meter square, so we will multiply it with 10 to the power 9, so it will become 2 into 10 to the power 10 newton mm square. So we have found all the areas, so what will be the slope? Theta, this is point B and this is point A, so theta B minus theta A will become, theta A minus theta B will become, different of the slopes will become equal to 1 upon EI into area. So total area between these two points will be equal to sum of these three areas. So it will be sum of these three areas. So we have done a mistake here. This is 1 by 2 into 1 into 20. So 20 by 2 will become 10. Okay, not 20. So is it 10 into, so 1 into 10 to the power 10. So total area will become 1 plus, this is A2 is 2 plus A3 is 3, 2 into 10 to the power 10. Okay, so it will become 10, 2 plus 2 plus 1, 5 into 10 to the power 10 divided by EI. So we will put the values of EI. So 5 into 10 to the power 10 into E divided by E is 10 to the power 5 into I is 10 to the power 8. So 5 into 10 to the power 10 minus 8, 5, 13. So 5 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. Okay, so it will become, if you can, sorry, it will be in radians because it is a slope, so it will be in radians. The slope will be theta A, will be theta B, will be 0.005 radians. Okay, so this is the slope, and next we have to find deflection. So YA will be equal to, from Mohr's formula, we have Mohr's theorem, A into X bar upon EI. So there are three areas, so there will be three centroids, so we will, it will be 1 upon EI into A1 X1 plus A2 X2 plus A3 X3. Okay, so it will become 1 upon EI into, see, this A1 is 10, 1 into 10 to the power 10, so it will be 1 into 10 to the power 10 into X bar will be distance of centroid, will be centroid will be at 2 by 3 into this distance, this total distance, so 2 by 3 into 1000 mm. This is 1 meter, so it will become 1000 mm. Okay, now for second part, it will be plus A2 is, A2 is 20, 2 into 10 to the power 10, and distance of centroid will be this 1 meter, this 1 meter plus half of this, so 1 by 2, so 1 plus 1 by 2, so it will become 3 by 2, so 3000 by 2 mm. Okay, and then plus area 3 will be equal to, A3 is 2 into 10 to the power 10, 2 into 10 to the power 10, as distance of centroid will be this 1 mm plus this 2 by 3 meter, 1 meter plus 2 by 3, 1 plus 2 by 3 into 1000. Okay, so 1 upon EI into, now it will be 20 by 3, okay, sorry, 2 by 3 into 10 to the power 13 plus, this 2 will cancel this 2, so it will become 3 into 10 to the power 13 plus this 3, 5 by 3, it will become 5 by 3, so 10 by 3 into 10 to the power 13. Okay, so if we will add all these 3, so it will become 7 upon 7 into 10 to the power 13 divided by EI. Okay, so we will put value of EI, 7 into 10 to the power 13 divided by E is 10 to the power 5 and I is 10 to the power 8. So it will become 7 into 10 to the power 13 divided by 10 to the power 13. So it will be 7 mm. So it will be deflection at free end of the cantilever beam. Okay, So I hope you understand how to find the slope and deflection by using moment area method. If you have any doubt, then please ask in the comment section. And if you like this video and understand this problem, then please share and subscribe my channel. And thanks for watching this video. And I is given as 10 to the power 8 mm to the power 4. So we have to calculate the bending moment diagram. We have to draw the bending moment diagram because we have to use the area moment method. So we will draw lines through all the loads and support, and bending moment will be negative because these loads are causing hobbing moment. So at this point bending moment will be 0 because 20 into 0 will be 0, and at this point it will be 20 into 1. So this will be 20, and this is a straight line, inclined line. Now at this point what will be the bending moment? So bending moment at A is equal to 20 into this 1, sorry, 20 into 2, 1 plus 1, 2, plus 20 into 1. So it will be 60 kilonewton meter. Okay, so this will become, this is 20, this will become 60, this is 60. Okay, we are not writing unit because of space constraint. We have less space, so we will draw a parallel line from here so that we can calculate area easily. So suppose this is 1 and this is 2 and this is 3 parts, so that we can denote it. Then area A1 will be, this area A1 will be equal to half, this is triangular, so half into base into height. So half into base is 1 meter and height is this 20, it is in kilonewton meter. Okay, sorry, kilonewton into meter square, because this load is in, this is in kilonewton meter, so it is in kilonewton meter, 20 kilonewton meter into this, is this length is in meter, so it is in kilonewton meter square. So if you will convert, because all the units are given in newton per mm square or mm to the power 4, so we have to convert into it into newton mm to the mm square. So it will become 20 into 1000, it will convert into newton, into 10 to the power 3 to the power square to convert meter square into mm square. So it will become 20 into 10 to the power 3 plus 6, 9, or 2 into 10 to the power 10 newton mm square. Okay, so this is area A1. Now area A2 will be base into height, it is rectangular area, so it will be base into height. So base is 1 into height is this 20, so 20 kilo newton meter square. So if we multiply it by 10 to the power 9, then it will become 2 into 10 to the power 10 newton mm square. Okay, now area A3 will become half into base into height, so base is 1 into height is this 60 minus 20 is 40, so it will become 20 kilo newton meter square. So we will multiply it with 10 to the power 9, so it will become 2 into 10 to the power 10 newton mm square. So we have found all the areas. So what will be the slope? Theta, this is point B and this is point A, so theta B minus theta A will become theta A minus theta B will become different of the slopes will become equal to 1 upon EI into area. So total area between these two points will be equal to sum of these three areas, so it will be sum of these three areas. So we have done a mistake here, this is 1 by 2 into 1 into 20, so 20 by 2 will become 10, okay, not 20. So is it 10 into, so 1 into 10 to the power 10. So total area will become 1 plus, this is A2 is 2 plus A3 is 2 into 10 to the power 10. Okay. So it will become 10, 2 plus 2 plus 1, 5 into 10 to the power 10 divided by EI. So we will put the values of EI. So 5 into 10 to the power 10 into E divided by E is 10 to the power 5 into I is 10 to the power 8. So 5 into 10 to the power 10 minus 8, 5, 13. So 5 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. Okay, so it will become, if you can, sorry, it will be in radians, because it is a slope, so it will be in radians. The slope will be theta A, will be theta B, will be 0.005 radians. Okay, so this is the slope, and next we have to find deflection. So YA will be equal to, from Mohr's formula we have, Mohr's theorem, A into X bar upon EI. So there are three areas, so there will be three centroids, so we will, it will be 1 upon EI into A1 X1 plus A2 X2 plus A3 X3. Okay, so it will become 1 upon EI into, see, this A1 is 10, 1 into 10 to the power 10. So it will be 1 into 10 to the power 10 into X bar will be, distance of centroid will be, centroid will be at 2 by 3 into this distance, this total distance, so 2 by 3 into 1000 mm. This is 1 meter, so it will become 1000 mm. Okay. Now for second part, it will be plus A2 is 20, 2 into 10 to the power 10, and distance of centroid will be this 1 meter, this 1 meter plus half of this, so 1 by 2, so 1 plus 1 by 2, so it will become 3 by 2, so 3000 by 2 mm. Okay, and then plus area 3 will be equal to A3 is 2 into 10 to the power 10, 2 into 10 to the power 10, as distance of centroid will be this 1 mm plus this 2 by 3 meter, 1 meter plus 2 by 3, 1 plus 2 by 3 into 1000. Okay, so 1 upon EI into, now it will be 20 by 3, okay, sorry, 2 by 3 into 10 to the power 13 plus, this 2 will cancel this 2, so it will become 3 into 10 to the power 13 plus this 3, 5 by 3, it will become 5 by 3, so 10 by 3 into 10 to the power 13. Okay, so if we will add all these 3, so it will become 7 into 10 to the power 13 divided by EI. Okay, so we will put value of EI, 7 into 10 to the power 13 divided by E is 10 to the power 5 and I is 10 to the power 8. So it will become 7 into 10 to the power 13 divided by 10 to the power 13. So it will be 7 mm. So it will be deflection at free end of the cantilever beam. Okay. So I hope you understand how to find the slope and deflection by using moment area method. If you have any doubt, then please ask in the comment section. And if you like this video and understand this problem, then please share and subscribe my channel. And thanks for watching this video.